Good YouTube, it's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, we got some huge news, as it seems that undefeated three-division world champion, former undisputed junior welterweight world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered by many to be the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. Terrence Crawford, 37 wins, no losses, no draws, 28 wins by way of knockout. He's 33 years of age, stands at 5'8" with a 74-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was November 14th when he took on and defeated former IBF welterweight world champion, British superstar boxer, Special K, Kell Brook, and knocked out Kell Brook in dramatic fashion. Now, we all know Terrence Crawford is set to be a free agent as he's currently signed to Top Rank. Legendary promoter, top-ranked CEO, Bob Arum, and he fights on the network of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. He will be a free agent in October, and it's being reported. My sources have told me that Terrence Crawford is already out the door. Terrence Crawford has cited that the way he's been treated, the way he's been promoted, he's not standing for it anymore. Terrence Crawford is out the door. Most people speculating as to, you know, we saw Terrence Crawford get on the airplane and he's heading to Dubai, and it looks like, you know, he was meeting with MTK Global, possibly signing with them. There's reports he could meet with Matchroom CEO and promoter Eddie Hearn, who has his fighters showcase their talents on DAZN streaming network. And obviously the big one everybody wants to see Terrence Crawford team up with and do business with is PBC, Premier Boxing Champions, with founder and advisor Al Haymon. With that said, we know that Terrence Crawford have been promised for the better part of 6 years for a showdown, a legacy showdown, a major, massive, payday with 8-division legendary, iconic Filipino superstar boxer Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao. Now, Terrence Crawford's rival, which he is the 50% of the 100% of the biggest fight in the sport of boxing between himself and undefeated, unified WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, who is currently reviewed and viewed as top 3 pound-for-pound fighters in the world, in Errol "The Truth" Spence Jr. Terrence Crawford makes up for 50%. Errol Spence makes up for 50%. They've been going back and forth as Errol Spence, he cited, well, I've been doing all the heavy lifting. I've been fighting a better opposition, and I'm doing the bigger pay-per-view numbers. Errol Spence, he fought 4-division world champion, Mexican superstar boxer, who was a Hall of Famer, and Mikey Garcia. That was his first pay-per-view, did 350,000 reported pay-per-view buys. Then he fought 2-time welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, who was going to be a Hall of Famer, and Showtime Sean Porter on pay-per-view. That did 325,000 pay-per-view buys. And then he fought 2-division world champion, unified junior welterweight world champion, and former WBC welterweight world champion, and Danny Swift Garcia, who was set to be a Hall of Famer, and that reportedly did 315,000 pay-per-view buys. So now we see those numbers trajected downwards, right? Because the popularity of his opponents and the circumstances, okay? He fought Danny Garcia coming off a 14-month layoff after suffering a horrific car accident just 12 days after unifying the belts against Sean Porter September 28th. October 10th, he suffered that horrific car accident. With that said, he fought Danny Garcia straight away. Now we're dealing with a global pandemic as well. So Errol Spence cited that he's doing bigger numbers because Terrence Crawford did 2 pay-per-views in which he fought Victor Postol, did a reported 60,000 pay-per-views, and then he fought Amir Khan on pay-per-view and then did 150,000. So combined, he did 210,000 pay-per-view buys. And Terrence Crawford let it be known that Bob Arum had informed him there's no money to promote Terrence Crawford on pay-per-view, okay? Bob Arum just recently stated that it would be a huge fight. It would be a big fight between Terrence Crawford and Showtime Sean Porter, but who's going to pay for it? Bob Arum is on record as stating that he personally blocked Terrence Crawford from getting a showdown with Manny Pacquiao for 2 reasons. For one, Manny Pacquiao was looking to receive $20 to $25 million. And he said he wasn't willing to pay that because he didn't believe that Terrence Crawford was a draw. And he didn't think that Manny Pacquiao at the time, after losing to Floyd Mayweather, was worth $20 to $25 million. He was happy he didn't have to fit the bill and take the loss. And he also cited that Manny Pacquiao is a close friend of his, and he didn't want to see Manny Pacquiao get hurt because he knows how it's going to end between Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao. So he didn't want to see Manny Pacquiao in that position. So he let it be known that he blocked the fight. So what would lead Terrence Crawford to believe that he was then move forward? That was 2.5 years ago. Bob Arum then came out and stated that he was trying to make the fight for Manny Pacquiao and Terrence Crawford in November. Instead of Kell Brook, it was supposed to be Manny Pacquiao. And then it was reported that June 5th would be this June 5th of 2021. It could be Manny Pacquiao and Terrence Crawford. But all signs point to Bob Arum never truly committing to wanting to make that fight happen for Terrence Crawford. And it seems like now Terrence Crawford, who had re-signed, and the boxing world was in a tizzy because everybody's like, why would Terrence Crawford re-sign and he can't get these big fights? And the PBC has all the best welterweights in the world on their side of the street, and you're putting a roadblock directly in between you guys. Nonetheless, Terrence Crawford, he made his debut at welterweight against Jeff Horn, the man who beat Manny Pacquiao, but most people felt like Jeff Horn shouldn't have gotten a nod, but he did anyway. He beat Jeff Horn, knocked out Jeff Horn, stopped Jeff Horn. Then he fought Jose Benavidez Jr. He beat and stopped Jose Benavidez Jr. Then he faced off against Amir Khan. That was pay-per-view, but it wasn't unsuccessful in the eyes of Bob Arum. He says that it was a horrible outing. You know, they didn't get a return on their investment, so he wasn't happy with it. Then he fought Igis Kavalaskis, who was his WBO mandatory challenger, and most recently he fought Kell Brook. So he's yet to secure the big lucrative fights and the legacy fights. He did a special with Andre Ward, Hall of Famer, former retired undefeated pound for pound king. And he sat down with Andre Ward and he stated when sitting down with Andre Ward that he's seeking that massive legacy lucrative fight. It's been eluding him for his entire career. And this is because he's been with Bob Arum, and Bob Arum is just not in belief that Terrence Crawford is a big draw. So, you know, he don't feel like he can get a return on his investment when it comes to Terrence Crawford. And now I believe that the boxing world has been calling for a fight with him and Errol Spence. Errol Spence said 60-40 in my favor because I'm doing all the heavy lifting. So for all this time, Terrence Crawford was trying to secure a fight with Manny Pacquiao. Then he stated it had to be 60-40 in his favor. With Errol Spence was the biggest fight in boxing, or a 50-50. And then he changed his tune and he said 50-50 is not enough. That fight is in his rearview mirror. He's focusing on Manny Pacquiao. He did the special with Andre Ward. He said his number one objective was to secure a fight with Manny Pacquiao. He was unable to do so. Bob Arum stated that it was $50 million pot on the table. Manny Pacquiao then upped his number from 25 to 40, and Terrence Crawford would get 10. And then Bob Arum stated that the investment group in Abu Dhabi, it fell through. And it just looks like Bob Arum is not looking to make this fight. And it fell through, according to Bob Arum, and they had to look elsewhere for Terrence Crawford. And then Bob Arum, he stated that Manny Pacquiao wasn't allowed to fight here in the States. But yet, out of the blue, we get Manny Pacquiao versus, you got it, Errol Spence Jr. And Errol Spence, he tweets out to Terrence Crawford, #BlameBob. So now the two biggest fights for Terrence Crawford are fighting each other. And one is going to eliminate Terrence Crawford, eliminate themselves from the Terrence Crawford sweepstakes. Because instead of Terrence Crawford being able to secure both fights for his legacy, now only one is going to be relevant that's left standing. Okay? And another fight that everybody's calling for is him and Sean Porter. And Bob Arum said there's no money for that. Who's going to put up the money for that? Then when Terrence Crawford was being mentioned to fight Keith Thurman, undefeated at the time, unified WBC, WBA, welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, who lost to his only losses to Manny Pacquiao, Bob Arum stated, why don't Keith Thurman and Terrence Crawford find another promoter to put up the money? I'll be sitting ringside to watch them lose money. So again, it's abundantly clear that Bob Arum, that's another legacy fight for Terrence Crawford. It's abundantly clear that Terrence Crawford is not, you know, the twinkle in Bob Arum's eye. He don't feel like he's a draw. He said he's difficult to deal with. So Bob Arum says that, you know, at one point in time, he just left it up to Todd DeBuff, his son-in-law, who helps run the company, to deal with Terrence Crawford because he didn't want to deal with Terrence Crawford. So now his two biggest rivals, his two biggest fights, his legacy, high-profile, high-lucrative fights are fighting one another. And he's left out in the cold again without an opponent. Then Bob Arum, he stated that Terrence Crawford is waiting for the winner, Josh Taylor, Jose Ramirez. Josh Taylor won the fight. He said the fight could happen in the fall, maybe in October, but it looks like it's not happening because it looks like Terrence Crawford is just going to wait it out and he's on his way out the door. So let's see how this unfolds and plays out. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
Oh, it is your boy Jaden Kiss. Make sure you check out Blue Blood Sports TV. It's going down.